This is the place where I wasted my life. This is the room where I waited for you. Now that I knew what I was waiting for, here is a pad where I wrote down your name. And here is a stain where the mattress used to lie. I lie, and all this remembering, this painful reverie, sure make a man hungry for burger and fries. So I will cross the mighty parking lot, the concrete divider and the retail shops, and the old shopping plaza where nobody goes, by the Polarama, the hit or miss, the floor shop payless and the moral kiosk, concrete windows in ancient Greece, cinder blocks, space police, walking through the drive-thru, the manager says hi. Before that, this place was a lucky one. 80 square feet working kitchen with functional features, doomed to be the home of third-rate fast food restaurants. I like the system here, I like the yellow and white, I like the stupid crown they give you when you purchase your Sprite. If I could, you know that I would stay here all night, just kicking back in my plastic booth, make me feel alright. Before they closed the Lucky Ones, this was a Nathan's Famous. For about 6 months they tried this place as a Jack in the Box. They tried giveaways, promotions, and generally acting shameless, and blameless as us nameless patrons of fast food restaurants. Not too many in here now except me and the flies, and a little Brad who's crying cause he got mustard in his eyes. His dad is scraping it off the back of the bun with a butter knife. It's all so deeply horrible, it's great to be alive. Before they closed the Jack in the Box, this was a Ponderosa. And before that it gets sketchy, but I remember a frightening lumps. The bathrooms were impeccable, but the tables could not be grosser. They served delicious irony in fast food restaurants. Oh, did I tell you I got a job now? Yeah, I've been working in the transport trade. Don't know what it is or what the hell I do, but I do get paid. Why don't you meet me at the Burger Express? I could buy you the Whammer, or the Slammer, or the Happy Meal. Please say yes. Yes, yes. But I guess you wouldn't like that.
You prefer something natural. One more instantiation on how you couldn't care less about the mighty parking lot and the concrete divider and the retail shops by the old shopping plaza that used to be hopping when I was a kid and my mama took me shopping. I remember sitting at the counter at Schnackenberg's, counting my pennies for a shot at the brass ring. This box does not contain instant winner, please try again. Before I was Napoleon, I think I was Cleopatra. In a past life, don't you think I was Genghis Khan? But now I'm me and I'm duty free like a truck dispatcher, doomed to spend my life in third rate fast food restaurants. Nobody looks at anybody, we're all nothing to see. There's no one within miles who could stir feelings of jealousy. This really is the perfect place for a loser like me. Scarfing double cheeseburgers and letting beans be. Before this was a strip mall, this was Colonial Wheatfield. Before that, this land was meant to be burial ground. And me, I take my stand by the salad bar with the plastic spit shield, filling little ketchup cups and hanging around. But I'm not going down. No, I'm not going down. I don't care, I don't care. I'm not going down.